state of Albania. Dr. Feride Mushidi, Executive Director of Kosovo Rehabilitation Center for Torture Victims. Distinguished dignitaries, women leaders, peace ambassadors, ladies and gentlemen, good evening to you all. It is truly inspiring and meaningful to be here today among so many distinguished and dedicated women leaders. On behalf of the Women's Federation for World Peace International, I am delighted and honored to welcome you tonight to the Global Women's Peace Leadership Banquet and Award Ceremony. There's a very famous singer in Korea, An Si-hwan is his name, and he has one of his most famous songs is called 사람이 꽃보다 아름답다, which translates into people are more beautiful than flowers. And when I look at all of you today, it reminds me of this song because all of you here are looking beautiful. It's a wonderful evening. Thank you all for being here. As Caroline mentioned, less than a year ago, I was appointed president of the Women's Federation for World Peace International, and I felt and still feel greatly honored and truly humbled to have been given the opportunity to be a part of such an important mission. Actually, I spent my whole life in ballet studios. I was a professional dancer until the age of 39, and now I'm directing two arts organizations. So it's a big jump. I've jumped a lot in the stage, but it's a big jump going from ballet to NGO director. And I have much to learn, so I'm learning as I go, and I feel I have so much to learn from all of you, which I hope to do, so that I can better assist WFWP to do a greater job in the future. WFWP's four principles state that all human beings are part of one global family under God. As I look through the work that has been done over these many years, by WFWP leaders and members all throughout the world, I was in total awe. As you could see in the video presentation, dedication and sacrificial service to humanity has been the thread, tying together thousands of humanitarian projects, conferences, and educational programs in over 150 nations. Many of our members have been serving in countries in Africa and the Middle East, all throughout the world for more than 20 years. The founders of WFWP, Reverend Sam Young-moon and Dr. Hak-cha Han-moon, whom we lovingly call True Parents, have dedicated and given every moment of their lives to God, to humanity, and to the cause of world peace, and have inspired so many others to do the same. When they established WFWP in 1992, our founders proclaimed the coming of the age of women, a turning point in history, stating that the world of war and violence, oppression and exploitation that has been led by men must come to an end, and a world of peace, love, and freedom must be realized through the nurturing, unconditional, maternal love of women, taking a more pivotal role. Our founders asked us not only to think of women's rights, but also exhorted us to build true families on the foundation of God-centered true love, and to educate, raise, and support women leaders, encouraging women all throughout the world to be initiators of peace by living for the sake of others. There is an unprecedented historic opportunity for us to usher in a world of peace and freedom if women can work together in solidarity to influence change, defend our priorities, and practice true love as mothers, wives, sisters, and daughters. And this is the purpose of Global Women's Peace Network. It is truly inspiring to see that here in Albania, almost 50% of the government ministers are women. In Korea, it's about 13%, and their goal is to bring it up to 30%. So we really, truly need this balance, I think, in areas of government. So when we see this, it is clear to see that Albania can become a model nation, leading the way in building an era of sustainable peace and harmony. harmony, just as our Mother Moon this morning so beautifully expressed in her address at the assembly. A path toward world peace, justice, and prosperity for all is indeed not an easy one, but surely is the most rewarding. This evening, we have gathered to celebrate some of those actions and lives that contribute to bringing us closer to that goal. These women invest their knowledge, talent, and hearts in service to their communities and nations. Thus, they contribute to making our world a better world for many others. I would also like to acknowledge the dedication and commitment made by all of you here tonight for everything that you do in your daily lives for the benefit of humanity. Your presence and your contributions are what make this evening so precious and meaningful. In addition, I would like to use this opportunity to extend my deep appreciation and gratitude to our UPF Europe President, Mike Malcolm. I hope he's somewhere here. And also to Carolyn Henshin, who is the International Vice President for WFWP Europe. Cartagena Minolari, who is the WFWP President here in Albania. And to the dedicated staff for all their efforts in preparing for this beautiful banquet and conference. Last but not least, I would like to thank our Mother Moon for bringing us all together and for providing the guiding vision and inspiration for this prestigious summit. Distinguished women leaders, I would now like to sit down and pass the podium to our next speaker, to Dr. Sun Jin Moon, who is my beloved sister-in-law and daughter of the founders of WFWP. For me, as her name is Sun Jin, she is life's sunshine. Always lovingly radiating warmth and light. The mission always came first, so as a young child, she and her 13 siblings had to share their parents with the world. Now, as a senior International Vice President of WFWP, and we're so blessed and honored to have you, she will convey to you more deeply the vision and heart of our founders. Once again, thank you all for being here with us tonight. Please enjoy this beautiful evening.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
She's the chairperson of the Pacific Rim Education Foundation in Kalua Kota, Hawaii. And maybe for many of us, or some of us in the room, we know her also for the incredible support that she gave to Mother Moon at the time when, after the passing of Dr. Sun Myung Moon, and she was always at her side. And it's such a lovely way to see this filial piety between daughter and mother, and at her side, walking to the podium with her, and it was really, really brought us to tears many, many times. So we're so grateful to welcome you, Dr. Sun Jin Moon.
In Germany on our way back. So that was a couple, I've seen some of you in Berlin, and we welcome you dignitaries, and great women leaders, Dr. Liri Berisha, First Lady of Albania, and Dr. Farini Rashidi, the Executive Director of Kosovo Rehabilitation Center for Torture Victims. Welcome. And also WFWP International, President Julia Moon, and as well as our previous president, Yana Moon, Dr. Yana Moon, all the leaders and members, participants in the Global Women's Peace Leadership Banquet and Awards Ceremony sponsored by the Women's Federation for World Peace. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a great pleasure to be here in Tirana, Albania, a beautiful city and a wonderful country, and to have the opportunity to offer words of welcome to all of you this evening, and especially to offer the warmest greetings on behalf of my mother, WFWP founder, Dr. Hak-Jahan Moon. Many of you heard her speak today at the very impressive opening plenary of the Southeast Europe Summit, where she gave a great blessing as Heavenly Albania. And even though you weren't accepted into the EU, to not lose hope, because you will be the future role model for the entire EU and the world. Moreover, she has very high hopes, not only that this conference will be a great success, but that it will serve as a major springboard for a victorious World Summit 2020 next February in Korea. The World 2020 Summit will be in culmination of not only my father's eminent legacy and profound works over 92 years on earth serving God and humanity, but also the culmination of my mother's equally grand and inspired visionary work, and exponentially expanding day by day, bringing higher enlightenment, mutual prosperity, and an end to suffering around the globe. Although my beloved father passed away 7 years ago, there is not a day that goes by that my mother and the worldwide organizations they established, including, of course, WFWP and GWPM, are not moving forward passionately and wholeheartedly to create a world of harmonious interdependence guided by universal values to achieve world peace in which we all live together as one family under God. As human beings, we all stand on the common ground and share the core ideals and values. We all want a world of peace. Yet unfortunately, we live in a world that often manifests the polar opposites of our heartfelt hopes. I know you are hoping for delicious food this evening, and I assure you that this hope will come true. Yes, I assure you. But before we start our dinner, I would like to leave you with some food for thought. After all, we are all gathered here to award great women peace leaders and are part of GWPM, which I believe is the greatest hope of peace in this world. But if you look at the world today, I ask the question, where is the peace? In the great wisdom of Socrates, of course he's not from Albania, but from this region, We have learned the Socratic method, where we engage our guests to answer and to have a dialogue with us. So in the spirit of this region, I ask you, where is the peace? Please feel free to shout out your response, because I know more than I can say anything to you. You are great leaders and teachers.
In God.
Yes.
In our hearts.
In your hearts, absolutely. Yes. There's no wrong answer.
In our family.
In your family. Yes, absolutely. Where else is the peace?
In God.
In God.
The heart of a true mother. Yes. Wonderful. Well, I point above, right?
God.
As true mother stated in her speech, mankind alone, womankind alone, human beings alone, without God, our heavenly parent, cannot achieve peace. So then I ask you another question. What is the source of all life?
Love.
Love. Yes, absolutely, love. And source of all life?
Humans.
Mothers, yes, all of you in this room. So Heavenly Parent is the spiritual life, the source of all life. And here we have the physical life. But what else is the source of all life? What's a mother of a mother? Where do we get sustenance to live our life, physical life?
The earth. The environment. The earth.
It's a hint. It's going to come on your plate.
Food.
Yeah. Where does it come from? The earth. Right? Mother Nature is a feminine entity. It gives us life. So now that you've answered all the questions, I don't have to talk anymore. But if you look everywhere, humanity and creation is in crisis everywhere we look. Nothing is more real and factual than what is happening to our Earth, our shared habitat. I bring up the Earth because it is our mother, the feminine of creation, the womb of all life on this planet, the nourisher, the nurturer, the ultimate giver of life. And what is happening to our mother Earth? Is it being taken care of responsibly?
No.
No, you all know the answer. Absolutely, and that's not right. We must cherish her as we must cherish all our mothers and our life givers. And as a courageous female and youth, when we think of future generations, activist Greta Thunberg, have you heard of her, has stood up to address this crisis, pointing out that the climate crisis poses a threat to our very existence. The thread of life that sustains all of us is being cut and polluted, torn apart by humanity's greed and corruption. Scientists speak of a sixth-level mass extinction as a web of life and a myriad of species on Earth are disappearing at an alarming rate. As our planet's natural resources are being sold out to a select few that profit, and the rest of creation is left out. The balance of life teeters on a dangerous ledge. We see this happening all around us as Earth and all life hangs on a cliff. Instead of preserving and living in harmony with our glorious creation, we are playing God in labs, for profit as a true natural help is abandoned, and we struggle to pay for healthcare or are left to suffer or perish. We fight over resources. The world economy vacillates as securities are ever more insecure. Desperation and mayhem, protests and unrest, mass migration, refugee crises, political polarization at the domestic and international levels, threatening past alliances and cooperative interdependence. Divisiveness plagues our communities and affects our governments, religions, the media, academia, and the society at large. Selfishness grows, and an ethics of service to others is in decline. In this region, I know as the work that our great women leaders have done, you have all witnessed the scars of such historical trauma. And peace is so very hard to find as we tirelessly try to hang on to navigate this unraveling thread of our humanity and our purpose in life. So why and where is the end to all these sad realities? That's a big question, right, after all that. The answer lies in, yes, every man, woman, and child. At the deepest level, there is a crisis of the human heart and conscience. There is a crisis rooted in the failure to understand our true identity. We do not know who we truly are. We have lost our most divine wisdom and have drifted from the higher level of consciousness, which is our true destiny. That is the reason we have failed to bridge the divide. Of all the sad and tragic issues listed above, we must know the divine truth that we are all precious brothers and sisters, and we must unite and live in harmony with creation as one family under God. My father, in his autobiography titled Peace Loving Global Citizen, knew the true value of our Mother Earth. As he said, human selfishness is destroying nature. Competition for the shortest route to economic success is a main reason that the Earth's environment has been damaged. We cannot allow the Earth to be damaged any further. Religious people must lead the way in an effort to save nature. Nature is God's creation and His gift to humankind. We must work quickly to awaken people to the preciousness of nature and the urgent need to restore it to its rich and free state enjoyed at the time of creation. The best environmental movement, however, is the one that spreads love. The shortest shortcut to protecting nature is to develop a heart that loves nature. We must be able to shed a tear at a sight of a single blade of grass that we see walking along the road. We must be able to grab hold of a tree and weep. We must understand that God's breath is hidden inside a single boulder or a single gust of wind. To care and love for the environment is to love God. We must be able to see each creature created by God as an object of our love. With our spiritual eyes open, we can see that a single dandelion by the roadside is more valuable than the gold crown of kings. What beautiful words, poetry, and divine truth. We must see the God in all life and creation. That is the only way we'll achieve peace. Also in my father's autobiography, he said that peace will be realized by women. A mother's loving and giving heart. Throughout history, women have been persecuted, but I predict this will change. The coming world will be one of reconciliation and peace based on a woman's maternal character, love, and sociability. The time is come when the power of women will save the world. That is a quote from my father. He is born in 1920s, North Korean, Asian patriarchal man. For him to have that vision of women will save this world is revolutionary. And today, in recognizing the importance of our coming together, developing the GWPN, as my father proclaimed, the power of women will save the world. Do you agree?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you. I sincerely believe, I know you're getting hungry. We'll get to that, I promise, right? I sincerely believe that we can inspire the world by our actions together, as our beautiful Congress lady at lunch. Okay. Together. The world is looking for a movement such as ours, a new paradigm, a movement that is characterized by the collaboration that leads women, that leads by example, with efforts to transform this world, putting an end to war, violence, conflict, and poverty, injustice, and the devastation of our Holy Mother Earth. Tonight we gather to affirm and advance women's leadership to honor the work and lives of two distinguished women leaders who have impacted the world in powerful ways. The women we are honoring tonight exemplify the ideals of love, service, and commitment, and true leadership. My hope, and the hope of my mother, the hope of WFWP and GWPN, is that we can combine and synergize all our collective efforts, uniting as one coalition of peace-building citizens of the world. Together with one heart, we can turn the tide of division, selfishness, corruption, environmental devastation, and end once and for all the senseless violence and suffering all humankind and creation has been. Women's Federation for World Peace has always promoted the bridge of peace from the time of its founding. Therefore, let us be bridges of peace to one another and to the world. A very special significance of all the work is the family, the true love of a mother and a father, the true love of parents and children that passed down to our tribes, our community, nation, and world. in WFWP, we say that the family is a school of love. Building strong, loving families is in itself an act of peace building. For this reason, I want to put in a special word about the Family Blessing Festival that takes place tomorrow afternoon. This will be a unique, uplifting celebration of strong, healthy families as a root of the future peace and the culture of heart we are all striving for, and something my parents have just dedicated their lives to. I hope you will all be able to attend. We also extend the invitation to all of you and your guests to the World Summit 2020 that takes place next February in Korea. This will be the greatest and most significant event ever carried out by my mother. It will be the greatest peace event, the centennial of my father's life. Something the world has never seen in terms of an assembly of world leaders from so many backgrounds and fields. I hope to see you all there. And finally, as I promised, I wish you a successful conference, a delicious dinner, thanks to the Mother Moon and Mother Earth. And thank you for your great leadership, your true stewardship for world peace. And may God always bless you and your precious families. Congratulations once again to our Women of Excellence, Global Women's Peace Awardees, and bon appetit.